In this segment, we want to see if a set of equations has unique solution or not. We're taking an example. So somebody's giving you three equations, three unknowns. This is the coefficient matrix. This is the solution vector. This is the right-hand side vector. So if you write it in the matrix form, in a shortened symbolic matrix form, we have Ax equal to C. So what we have to check is, what we're being asked is that, hey, can you tell us whether it has a unique solution? So the first thing which I want to do is I want to find rank of A. So I want to find the rank of the coefficient matrix, and it turns out to be 2. You'll have to work it out to see that why the rank of A is 2. So it turns out to be 2. Rank of the augmented matrix also turns out to be 2. So the augmented matrix will be simply taking the right-hand side vector, adding it as the fourth column to the A matrix, and then finding the rank of that 3 rows and 4 column matrix, and it turns out to be 2. So what you're finding out is that rank of A is same as the rank of the augmented matrix, which is 2, which simply means that it is a consistent system of equations. So this set of equations which you have here is consistent. What do we mean consistent? Consistent means that it has a solution. Either the solutions are, the number of solutions is 1, is unique, or it is infinite. So we have to now make a decision based on this, what we have found now, that it's a consistent system of equations. Hey, do we have unique solutions, unique solution, or do we have infinite solutions? So how are we going to do that? We're going to basically check what the rank of A is, and we're going to check the number of unknowns. And we're finding out that the rank of A is 2, number of unknowns is 3, because 1, 2, 3. So rank of A in this case is less than the number of unknowns. And since that is the case, we'll have infinite solutions. And that's the end of this segment.